السلام عليكم. Lecture 5 of the renal system.
In this lecture, we will discuss the factors that regulate tubular reabsorption. The physical forces that control the tubular reabsorption, which include the peritubular, capillary, and renal interstitial fluid physical forces.
Today, we will talk about the peritubular, capillary, and the renal interstitial fluid physical forces. Normally, more than 99% of all the water and solute which are reabsorbed from the tubular lumen to the interstitial fluid, and it will then will it reabsorb to the peritubular capillary. Any increase in the peritubular capillary absorption lead to an increased reabsorption from the renal tubule والعكس صحيح. هذه العملية due to the changing of the physical forces اللي هي عبارة عن hydrostatic and colloid osmotic pressure of the protein in the renal interstitium which surrounding the tubules. The normal peritubular capillary reabsorptive rate is about 124 milliliter per minute, which is calculated as filtration coefficient multiplied by net reabsorptive force. The filtration coefficient هو equal to the 12.4 multiplied by 10 اللي هي net reabsorptive force اللي راح نحسبها هسه بعد شوية. So it's equal to the 124 milliliter per minute. أنتم تذكرون أن الجلوميرولار فلتريشن ريت يعني كمية المعدل الفلويد اللي صابينه فلتريشن من الجلوميرولاي هو 125 مللتر بير مينت. من هاي ال 125 اللي صاب بيها فلتريشن ونزلت إلى الرينال تيوبيول 124 مللتر بير مينت راح ترجع إلى البلاد. أوكي؟ So why this normal rate of peritubular capillary fluid reabsorption اللي هو 124 milliliter per minute is high. Why? Due to the two causes. First of all, the net reabsorptive force about 10 millimeter mercury, which is favor the reabsorption into the peritubular capillaries, which represent the summation of multiple forces include هي تذكرون نفس الفورسز اللي حكينا عنها بالجلوميريو فلتريشن ريت هذه نفسها ولكن المفروض تكون بشيء معاكس لانه بالجلوميريو فلتريشن فلتريشن نزول الفلود فيفر ذا فلتريشن داونورد هون ات فيفر ذا ري ابزوربشن فاشني الفورسز first of all it is peritubular capillary hydrostatic pressure البيريتيوبير كابيلاري هيدروستاتيك بريشر الهيدروستاتيك بريشر ات ذا كابيلاري ايكوال تو 13 مليمتر ميركوري اند ذا كولويد اوزموتيك بريشر اوف ذا بروتين ان ذا رينال انترستيتيوم ايكوال تو ذا 15 مليمتر ميركوري بوث اوف ذيم اوبوز ري ابزوربشن يعكسون الري ابزوربشن تو ذا بيريتيوبير كابيلاري الباور another two power اللي هي hydrostatic pressure in the renal interstitium which equal to the 6 millimeter mercury and the colloid osmotic pressure of the peritubular capillary plasma protein اللي هي 32 millimeter mercury both of them will favor reabsorption. This picture will explain to you the what we said in the previous slide. Here, this is the tubular lumen. هذا اللي tubular cell. هاي interstitial fluid. هاي peritubular capillary. الفلود المفروض من الجلوميرولار صار بيها filtration ونزلت بالtubular fluid بالtubular lumen sorry. راح يصير بيها reabsorption to the tubular cell and then to the interstitial fluid. هوني اكو فورسز راح تتحكم بها حتى يصير بها reabsorption again to the peritubular capillary وقلنا النت reabsorption يعني راح يصير الريت اوف ذا reabsorption هو 124 مللتر بير مينت اشني الفورسز اللي تتحكم بها اولا عندنا the peritubular capillary hydrostatic pressure اللي هو 13 مليمتر mercury which oppose which oppose reabsorption. Oppose reabsorption يعني يعاكس الreabsorption، لأن الreabsorption المفروض يكون هالشكل، هذا oppose reabsorption. وأيضا عندنا ال colloid osmotic pressure at the interstitium. هذا الكولويد اوزموتيك بريشر ات ذا انترستيتيوم اللي هي 15 ملم مركري، ايضا ويل اوبوز ريابسوربشن تو ذا بيريتيوبيرال كابيلاري. اشني القوه اللي تساعد على الريابسوربشن تو ذا بيريتيوبيرال كابيلاري؟ مينلي هي البيريتيوبيرال كابيلاري كولويد اوزموتيك بريشر اللي هي 32 ملم مركري، وايضا الهيدروستاتيك بريشر ات ذا انترستيتيوم اللي هي 6 ملم مركري، سوري ملم مركري، يس، بوث اوف ذيم ويل فيفر ذا ريابسوربشن تو ذا بيريتيوبيرال كابيلاري. سو ذا نت ريابسوربشن بريشر از وذ ذا reabsorption to the peritubular capillary اللي هي 10 millimeter mercury with the reabsorption to the peritubular capillary. The second cause of the high rate of the reabsorption to the peritubular capillary is the large filtration coefficient اللي هو equal to the 12.4 milliliter per minute per millimeter mercury. This is due to the high hydraulic conductivity and large surface area of the capillaries. What are the factors which regulate the tubular reabsorption? We have multiple factors. First of all, it is glomerular tubular balance. Glomerular tubular balance, أشنون نعرفها. It is the intrinsic ability of the tubules to increase their reabsorption rate with constant percentage. With constant percentage in response to increased tubular load. Mean increased glomerular filtration rate. This balance occurs mainly in the proximal tubules and less in the lobe of Henle. For example, if the glomerular filtration rate increase from the 125 to 150 milliliter per minute, the rate of proximal tubular reabsorption will increase in the same percentage, also from the about 81 to about 97.5 milliliter per minute. Both of them is 65% of the glomerular filtration rate. يعني الزيادة راح تكون بنفس النسبة. Okay, both of them 65 from يعني 81 هي 65 من 125 وال 97.5 هي 65 from the 150 of the glomerular filtration rate. Okay, the glomerular tubular balance prevent شنو فائدته؟ It prevents the overloading of the distal tubular segment when the glomerular filtration rate increases. And it is the second line of defense to buffer the effect of the spontaneous glomerular filtration changes in the urine output. احنا ذكرناكم بالمحاضرات السابقة the first line of defense. Okay, this is the second line of defense to buffer the effect of spontaneous changes of the glomerular filtration rate on the urine output. The second factor which regulates the peritubular reabsorption is peritubular capillary and renal interstitial fluid physical forces. First of all, اللي كان مثل ما وضحنا عندنا ال peritubular capillary hydrostatic pressure. Peritubular capillary hydrostatic pressure and مثل ما قلنا ال peritubular capillary hydrostatic pressure عادة oppose reabsorption. هو oppose يعني يعاكس الreabsorption. So the factor which increase it راح تقلل لنا reabsorption, and the factor which decrease it راح تزيد لنا peritubular capillary reabsorption. أشني الفاكتور أو بماذا يتأثر؟ First of all by the arterial pressure. It's influenced by the arterial pressure. The arterial pressure have a positive relationship with the peritubular capillary hydrostatic pressure. كلما زاد الارتيريال بريشر كلما زادت البيريتيوبيلار كابيلاري هيدروستاتيك بريشر از ويل، وايضا وبالنهايه راح لنا والاوبوز ريابسوربشن. سكند فاكتور اللي هو الريزيستنت ريزيستنس اوف ذا افرنت اند ذا افرنت ارتيريول ريزيستنس اوف ذا افرنت اند افرنت ارتيريول which have negative relationship with the peritubular capillary hydrostatic pressure. كلما قلت resistance for the afferent and efferent arteriole راح تزيد لنا peritubular capillary hydrostatic pressure، وبالنتيجة راح تقلل لنا peritubular capillary reabsorption. The second forces اللي هي peritubular capillary colloid osmotic pressure. Peritubular capillary colloid osmotic pressure هذا مثل ما قلنا it's favor reabsorption, increase reabsorption which determined by the بماذا تتحدد by the systemic plasma colloid osmotic pressure which have a positive relationship. يعني كلما زادت السيستميك بلازما كولويد اوزموتيك بريشر كلما زادت البيريتيوبيرال كابيلاري كولويد اوزموتيك بريشر، وبالنهايه راح يزيد البيريتيوبيرال كابيلاري ريابسوربشن. سكندلي ديتيرمايند باي ذا فلتريشن فراكشن. فلتريشن فراكشن ايضا بوزيتيف ريليشن شيب، كلما زاد الفلتريشن فراكشن راح يزيد البيريتيوبيرال كابيلاري اوزموتيك بريشر، وبالنهايه راح يزيد لنا البيريتيوبيرال كابيلاري ريابسوربشن. الفلتريشن فراكشن هاز ا بوزيتيف ريليشن شيب وذ ذا ريابسوربشن ريت، بوت ات ريمين ريليتيفلي كونستانت ان موست فيسيولوجيكال كونديشن. وهذا السلايد يوضح لنا الكلام اللي حكيناه في السلايدات السابقة، أنه زيادة البيريتيوبيلار كابيلاري هيدروستاتيك بريشر راح يقلل لنا الريابسوربشن. The peritubular capillary hydrostatic pressure is influenced by the resistance of the afferent and efferent arteriole. Decrease the resistance will increase the peritubular capillary hydrostatic pressure، وبالنتيجة راح يقلل لنا الريابسوربشن. وايضا increase arterial pressure راح يزيد لنا peritubular capillary hydrostatic pressure، وبالنتيجه راح يقلل لنا reabsorption. الفاكتور الثاني وهو peritubular colloid osmotic pressure its increase it will increase reabsorption of the peritubular capillary determined by the peritubular which is determined by the colloid systemic colloid osmotic pressure. Increase systemic colloid osmotic pressure increase peritubular colloid osmotic pressure, and finally it will increase the absorption. Filtration fraction increase will increase peritubular colloid osmotic pressure, and finally increase the absorption. Filtration coefficient which is constant, if it is increased it will increase the absorption. الفاكتور الاخر هو effect of the arterial pressure on the urine output lead to two terms which are called pressure natriuresis and pressure diuresis mechanism. اشنو تفسيره؟ A small increase, even a small increase in the arterial pressure lead to increase the urinary excretion of the sodium and the water. The increase the urinary secretion of the sodium, it's called pressure natriuresis, and the urinary increase the urinary excretion of the water, it's called pressure pressure diuresis. These contribute to the several factors. This factor, first of all, a slight increase in the glomerular filtration rate due to the autoregulation اللي حكيناها بالمحاضرات السابقة. Secondly, an increase in the peritubular capillary pressure will decrease in the tubular absorption percentage of the sodium and water. ليش? Due to the increases in the peritubular capillary hydrostatic pressure and subsequently to the increases in the renal interstitial fluid hydrostatic pressure. Thirdly, reduced in the angiotensin 2 formation due to the reduced in the angiotensin 2 formation lead to the decreased tubular sodium reabsorption, as will be discussed later. This picture show you that normally this the net reabsorption rate. Here, when there is an increase in the peritubular capillary hydrostatic pressure led to the decreased net reabsorption rate and will increase back leak of the fluid to the tubular lumen. A factor الرابع which control the tubular reabsorption, it is the hormonal control. What type of the hormones which participate in the tubular reabsorption? أولا عندنا الألدوسترون. Its action on the principal cells, which increases the sodium reabsorption and potassium secretion, and that's why stimulating the sodium potassium ATPase pump. Secondly, angiotensin 2. Angiotensin 2 increases the sodium and water reabsorption from the renal tubules through the three main effects. First, by it stimulates aldosterone secretion. Firstly, by stimulates the aldosterone secretion. Secondly, it constricts the efferent arteriole, leading to reduce the peritubular capillary hydrostatic pressure and increases the concentration of the protein and colloid osmotic pressure in the peritubular capillary. Both will raise the sodium and water reabsorption. Both will raise the sodium and water reabsorption. ثالثا, it directly will stimulate the sodium reabsorption in the proximal tubule and the loop of Henle and the distal tubules and collecting tubule by stimulating the sodium potassium ATPase pump on the tubular epithelial basolateral membrane and stimulating as well the sodium hydrogen exchange in the luminal side of the tubular renal tubular cell, especially in the proximal tubule. الهرمون الآخر اللي هو antidiuretic hormone. Antidiuretic hormone it increases the water permeability of the distal tubule, collecting tubule and collecting duct epithelial. Lead to the conserving water, especially in the dehydration. الهرمون الآخر هو الـ arterial natriuretic peptide. The specific cells of the cardiac arteria, when distended because of the plasma volume expansion, lead to the secrete special peptide called arterial natriuretic peptide. This peptide will inhibit the reabsorption of the sodium and the water by the renal tubules, especially at the collecting duct, and it will increase urinary excretion of sodium and water, which help to return the blood volume back toward normal. الهرمون الآخر هو parathyroid hormone. The parathyroid hormone will increase the calcium reabsorption by the distal tubule and loops of Henle, and it also inhibits phosphate reabsorption by the proximal tubule and stimulate magnesium reabsorption by the loop of Henle. And this picture show you the hormones that regulate the tubular reabsorption, the hormones and site of action and their effect, which we explained before. The final factor which regulate the tubular reabsorption is sympathetic nervous system activation. When there is activation of the sympathetic nervous system, lead to the decreases sodium and water excretion by two methods. Firstly, by constricting the renal arterioles, which lead to reducing the glomerular filtration rate. Secondly,
increasing the sodium reabsorption in the proximal tubule, thick ascending limb of lobe of Henle, and perhaps in more distal part of the renal tubule. Thirdly, the activation of the sympathetic nervous system lead to the increasing renin release.
From this lecture, we can conclude that there is a high rate of peritubular capillary fluid reabsorption equal to 124 milliliter per minute. The main factors that regulate tubular reabsorption are glomerulotubular balance, peritubular capillary and renal interstitial fluid physical forces, the effect of the arterial pressure on urine output, hormones, and finally sympathetic nervous system activation.
Thank you.